Clownfish, written by Beth Costanzo. Watch our amazing clownfish video. Try your expertise with our amazing clownfish quiz. In our exploration of some of our ocean's most fascinating creatures, we have finally arrived on one of the coolest looking fish. In fact, if you have seen the movie Finding Nemo, you will know what I'm talking about. The clownfish. The clownfish is a beautiful fish. Depending on the particular species, you can find clownfish in colors like yellow, orange, or a blackish or reddish color. Along with these distinctive colors, clownfish show many white patches or bars. This orange color and white bar, for instance, is what Nemo and Marlin look like in Finding Nemo. Their distinctive colors make clownfish some of the most recognizable and stunning fish in our waters. Clownfish, compared to other fish in our oceans, are pretty small. The largest clownfish can reach about 6.7 inches, while the smallest is about 2.8 to 3.1 inches long. Overall, clownfish need to be careful when swimming because larger predators can eat them. There are many different species of clownfish. In fact, there are 30 of them. These 30 species of clownfish live in several different habitats. Most notably, they are found in the warmer waters of the Indian and Pacific Oceans. If you are on vacation in Japan, Southeast Asia, Indonesia, or Australia, you may be able to spot a clownfish in the wild. Having said this, clownfish often live at the bottom of shallow seas, meaning that you may need to snorkel or scuba dive to see them. These fish live in sheltered reefs or shallow lagoons and near things called sea anemones. These sea anemones, among other things, can help protect clownfish from predators. Clownfish are omnivores. This means they eat both fish and plants. Some of their favorite foods include small zooplankton along with algae. Along with this food, clownfish may also eat on some of the undigested food found on anemones. As far as predators, clownfish may be eaten by larger fish, sharks, and eels. But putting aside those fish, one of the greatest threats to clownfish is humans. Humans don't eat clownfish, but rather catch them and put them in tanks or aquariums. Because of this, clownfish have a very unique relationship with sea anemones. The sea anemone helps protect the clownfish from predators and provides scraps of food that the clownfish can enjoy. It can also serve as a nest site for the clownfish. As for the clownfish, it gives back to the sea anemone in a number of ways. First, the clownfish can defend the sea anemone from different types of predators and parasites. The clownfish's frequent swimming around the sea anemone can create greater water circulation. The nitrogen that leaves the clownfish's body can even increase the number of algae in the sea anemone, which can help the anemone in tissue growth and tissue regeneration. As you can see, the clownfish and sea anemone need each other. They provide lots of help to each other and can make each other safer and healthier. So if you see a clownfish in the wild, don't be surprised if you see a sea anemone nearby. One of the most fascinating things about clownfish is the way that they have babies and get older. In terms of babies, clownfish lay their eggs on a flat surface that is close to their sea anemone. Depending on the specific species, some clownfish can lay hundreds or thousands of eggs at a time. The male parent of the eggs guards the eggs until they hatch, which is often 2 hours after sunset. After clownfish are born, they develop into males. When these clownfish mature, however, they actually become females. Once they transform into females, they can't turn back into males. Females lead a group of clownfish. And when that female leader dies, one of the largest and most dominant males becomes the leading female. It is a fascinating evolution and one that is actually quite common in the natural world. Finally, one of the coolest things about clownfish is the way that they communicate. clownfish talk to each other by making popping and clicking noises. Even though we may not be able to hear them when we're swimming, they are speaking to each other. One of the main reasons is that they're trying to prevent fights. It helps keep the group in line so that conflict does not break out.
Please subscribe to my YouTube page for more fun videos.
Visit us at www.adventuresofscubajack.com. Watch our amazing clownfish video. Try your expertise with our amazing clownfish quiz.
Everybody, and follow me.
From the beach to the culvert and the sea.
It's time for learning, it's time for fun.
It's a great adventure for everyone.
Come on, everybody, and follow me.
Jump and swim out to the bottom of the sea.
It's time for adventure, fun, and learning.
Scuba Jack. It's a shark attack!
Yay!
Hey everybody, it's Miss Beth from The Adventures of Scuba Jack. Please comment below and give us a thumbs up if you liked our video with activity book. See you soon.